Here. So we got Billie Eilish getting older. I'm not doing this in any specific order, but this is one of the tracks from Happier Than Ever. We probably should do this in some type of order, right, or not?
Yeah, let's do it in order.
Ah, fuck it.
No, let's do it in order. There's a reason why there's an order, right?
I mean, I kind of like spontaneity, no?
I mean, I get it, but we watch episodes in order.
I mean, I wouldn't be opposed to watching them out of order. Yo, who used to write books like that? Was it Captain Underpants where you'd read something and then say, hey, turn to page 63. And then you're on page 63 and then say, hey, turn to page 12. Was that Goosebumps?
I never read Captain Underpants. Hey.
How did you never read Captain Underpants? That's just classic.
I read the Zach Files. Do you remember that?
Yeah. No. Actually, sorry.
I feel like your default or like your autopilot answer is yeah.
It's like, yeah, no. All right, this is, oh, see? Hey. I was already going in order. Let's go. All right, so this is track number one, which is Getting Older. Are you ready?
I'm getting older, I think I'm aging well. I wish someone had told me I'd be doing this by myself. There's reasons that I'm thankful, there's a lot I'm grateful for. But it's different when a stranger's always waiting at your door. Which is ironic, cause the stranger seemed to want me more than anyone before. Too bad they're usually deranged. Last week, I realized I crave pity. When I retell a story, I make everything sound worse. Can't shake the feeling that I'm just bad at healing. And maybe that's the reason every sentence sounds rehearsed. Which is ironic, because when I wasn't honest, I was still being ignored. Crying for attention, just to get an inclusion. Now we're estranged. Things I once enjoyed just keep me employed now.
She says a lot. The part that kind of stuck out to me, there's a couple parts that stuck out to me, but one of the parts that stuck out to me was when she said she gets more support sometimes from strangers than she does from people that are close to her.
So I think you have to realize that she's saying she gets more attention. And I wonder if it's about the stalker that I've read about. In the comments, there was a stalker that would stalk her at her house. And so if you think about that and how the stalker wants her, that's...
Yeah.
Like, that's not the attention that you want. So I kind of understand where she's coming from. Like, she seeks attention, but it's from specific people.
I see.
And so her saying that it's ironic that she gets more attention from strangers... It is. It's very ironic. We always seek what we don't have.
Yeah.
Or usually.
And even like the last line she said, where like the thing she loves now just keeps her employed.
Yeah. What do you think about that?
I mean, it makes me think of people that like do what they love, but they do it regularly, or you do it for a job. I forgot where I read it, where sometimes you don't want to do what you love. Like, so for instance, like if you really love driving, you don't necessarily want to be a driver, because after a while, like, you're going to hate driving. You no longer love it, because now you're kind of forced to do it over and over and over again. Or if you like to analyze things, let's say you're a referee, you could never watch a game the same, because now you're so focused on analyzing the game that it's no longer fun. You're not doing it for the purposes of enjoyment or entertainment. You're doing it for like monetary reasons, or you're doing it because like it's your career. So I think it changes the aspect of doing things you actually enjoy.
I agree with you. I also wonder if she's not only talking about career. It could easily be a relationship where you want someone, and when you finally have that person, you realize that the relationship is not what you thought it would be, and that it becomes work. You know when relationships become work for you?
Yeah. Then you just want to quit.
Come out.
Things I once enjoyed just keep me employed now. Things I'm longing for. Someday I'll be bored of it so.
Up real quick. Or do you know how old she is?
I don't even think she's 21.
Yeah, which makes a lot of sense. Like, I think
She's
anyone,
19.
she's 19. Yeah. I think everyone gets to a point where they start to come into these realizations that she's like, that's like, that like she's going through. Like, first of all, like she says, like everything seems heavy on her shoulders, because the older you get, like you start to realize like how much of what you do is like responsibility, right? It's not like when you're a kid, like a lot, like you have some responsibility, but it's nowhere near the amount you start to endure as you're an adult. You realize, like, as an adult, like almost everything you do is like responsibility, and she says she has to prioritize her pleasure. That sounds like she just does a lot of, at least for the most part, like a lot of what she does is focused on like her career, her work, her responsibilities, and she doesn't prioritize her pleasure. So it's interesting that she's like coming into this realization. I can imagine just being 19 years old in her situation, like the amount of responsibility she has in comparison to an average 19-year-old is probably so much more, because I'm sure a lot of people are eating off her talent, you know?
Said we care so. somewhere laughing for anybody asking. I promise I'll be fine. I've had some trauma, did things I didn't wanna, was too afraid to tell ya, but now I think it's time.
Oh my gosh, like that first song, I'm guessing that's the intro song. So freaking sad.
Yeah, and I think it's a good way to introduce the album, because like she's essentially talking about her transition into adulthood, I think.
And then she talks about being abused.
And that too, yeah. And yeah, and that could come in many ways. Like, what do you think about like relationship abuse?
Yeah, like verbal probably.
But I would imagine like even as an artist, like the amount that's expected from you. So I can see that. I can see artists being abused, especially someone relatively young.
Yeah, I automatically think of like an overworked cow.
Right, exactly.
Like constantly having to produce milk.
Right. Like I could immediately think of Britney in that situation. She was very young, so early on she's being milked.
Mm-hmm.
Like hence your cow reference, right? Yeah. So like when you have that much talent and literally a lot of people are working because you have that talent. You know, you have people that are like PR, marketing, people in your label, producers, like a lot of people eat. So artists like that get, it's just a lot of pressure, I think. Security, entourages, you know?
Yeah, I love how real her lyrics are. Like she questions things, she finds things weird, how you want something and then when you finally get it, you get bored of it, which is so relatable for everyone today.
Yeah.
Especially when you have the money to do everything you want. It can get really old easily.
Yeah, I actually think that's when you can kind of take things for granted because you can experience things pretty frequently versus, like, I remember being a kid, like, you don't have access to do whatever you want because you don't have the access to that kind of money.
Mm-hmm.
So as a kid, when you have something, if you have ice cream and you literally only have ice cream like once a week, like you really appreciate that ice cream. Like as an adult, if you want, like you can just completely splurge and like whatever you want every single day. And I think become like gluttonous.
Yeah, 100%.